Welcome to Proverbs for Life Today, a ministry of ChristAssembly.org. My name is Bert Allen. I heard the story one time about a woman who pulled up to a stoplight and stopped, and there's a turn lane, and there are two turn lanes. And another car pulled up right beside her, and she's kind of pretty, and the construction workers in that other car rolled down their window and started saying stuff to her. But it's stuff she took exception to. And she rolled down her window and yelled and screamed at them so loudly that those guys rolled up their windows and pulled away as soon as they could. But we're going to look at a proverb today. And the proverb says, "A gentle answer turns away wrath, but a hard word stirs up anger." Proverbs chapter 15, verse 1. You see that story I heard about a woman. I understand too that the woman had a gun. She didn't pull it out, but she was a tough kind of woman. And when people gave her the business, she was prepared to give double business back to them, maybe triple. And sometimes that works, and sometimes it doesn't work. But there's a real general principle that will always be true. When people are already getting mad at you and you're going to give them a harsh word in return, it's only going to stir up more anger. And when you stir up a lot of anger, where both parties are really full of anger, there's no telling what's going to happen next. But there's a way to diffuse anger. And we should all keep this in mind, that a gentle answer turns away wrath. Remember that. Next time you see somebody really angry, and they're angry at you, and often it can be because you've done something wrong, or maybe you're just testifying for Christ that day, but you're going to encounter the wrath of people, and what do? You remember this proverb. It might save your life someday. That a gentle answer turns away wrath, but if you respond in kind, a harsh word stirs up anger. So if somebody's trying to ask you why you're doing something and you just go off on them, all you're going to do is be stirring up more and more anger. You're going to stir up anger in ways you really don't want to go there. How many times have you been in a fight at home with your spouse, your children, and you're just stirring up anger as fast as you can go between both of y'all? And it's getting worse and worse and worse, and you don't know what's going on, except that both y'all are so angry you can't stand it. You remember, if you let other people decide how you're going to react, then you're not following God. You're not walking behind Jesus. You see, we never let other people decide how we're going to act. Just because they're full of wrath doesn't mean that we have to be full of wrath. We can listen to Jesus and see, okay, what words do you want me to give back to the person who's really mad? And he goes, well, remember in Proverbs 15, I told you, a harsh word stirs up anger. So if you want to put a dispute to rest, if you want to turn away wrath in the family and your friends at work, wherever it might be, or at school, remember, a gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. Proverbs 15:1. So let's pray. Father, we pray that we would remember your word, that we'll remember that a gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up strife. Father, help us to remember that when we act in anger and do things to people, we're really not showing the mercy and love of God. Father, we pray that we would follow your Son and hear his voice talking through the Scriptures all the time. May we be ready with a gentle anger, with a gentle answer, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Before I close the video, I'd like to share with you four verses about eternal life. I often ask people this simple question: why should Jesus let you into heaven? And the answer to that question surprises many people because it comes from the Bible and it's simple and it's clear. Most folks, when they hear that question, they tell me, well, I've been good, or tried to do more good than bad, or I tried hard, or I've done a lot of nice things, and I hope God will let me into heaven. They somehow think if their good works outweigh their bad works, that God will let them in. But God says, actually, I'll let people into heaven because of a free gift. But the story from Jesus starts with four verses, and I'm going to read them one at a time. Romans 3:23 says, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. You see, for every person who lives today on earth in human flesh, we've all sinned, every one of us. We've all told a lie. We've all done or said something that made somebody else angry, and we were doing it out of anger ourselves. We've all done things to hurt other people at one time or another. God says that's all sin, and I look upon that as falling short of my glory, God says. God says we should never fall short of his standard, which is the glory of God. Well, is it serious that we've sinned? Should I be worried about that? Everybody sinned. Why should I worry? Well, consider Romans 6:23. For the wages of sin is death. That all of us deserve the death penalty. At the moment we sinned, we incurred the death penalty for the smallest sin or the biggest sin. I'm happy that Romans 6:23 continues and says, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. You see, if you've been listening carefully and thinking about what the Bible says, so far we've learned that we're all sinners, we all fall short of the glory of God, and we all deserve the death penalty. This doesn't sound like good news until you read the last part of that last verse. It says that God has a free gift for all of us. It's in Christ Jesus our Lord, and it's eternal life. The free gift of eternal life that only Jesus Christ can give you. He said he's the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father but through him. Why would God offer us this great gift if we're all sinners? Well, Romans 5:8 tells us. It says, but God demonstrates his own love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. He died for us. He died in our place. God loves sinners like you and like me. He died in my place and in your place. He paid the death penalty for me. I often illustrate the free gift like this. That I have this old Nissan truck. It has 285,000 miles on it. It's not that great a truck. It sits at the beach every day. But I illustrate the point this way. I hold up the keys to my truck and I say, I'm going to make you a symbolic gift of my truck. But until you take the keys out of my hand, it's not your truck yet. Well, let me tell you what I mean. A lot of people have been going to church for years. They know all about Jesus. They can quote verses about Jesus. But they know in their heart that they're not quite right with God. And there's never been a day in their life where they've been born again and they know it. You see, they're just staring at the keys in God's hand, and he's offering you the free gift today of saying, reach out by faith and receive that free gift and take it into your heart today. Receive the free gift. Okay, how do we do that? Well, Romans 10:9 tells us how to do that. It says that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And he means saved from the death penalty, eternal destruction. So we can receive that free gift right now by faith, and we can pray a prayer together. I urge you to pray with me. I'm going to pray it right now. Lord Jesus, I thank you that you love me. I confess that I am a sinner and I fall short of the glory of God. I confess too that I deserve the wages of sin, which is death. But Lord, you offer me the free gift of eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. I accept that free gift right now. I believe that you love me, and that God died on the cross for me, that Jesus Christ is God, and he died on the cross for me. You paid the death penalty for me, Lord Jesus. Thank you so much. I confess with my mouth Jesus is Lord, and I believe in my heart that God raised him from the dead. I repent of my sins, and I accept that free gift, Lord. Thank you so much that you have forgiven me. In your name I pray. Amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer with me, I'd love you to send me an email and we'll rejoice together. Send me the email at friend@christassembly.org. That's friend@christassembly.org. I look forward to hearing from you. Hallelujah.
Scripture quotations taken from the NASB, New American Standard Bible, copyright 1995 by the Lachman Foundation. Used by permission, all rights reserved.